Morning, everybody. Welcome to the Rockingham County Board of Commissioners meeting. Called this meeting to order for August 15th at 8:30 a.m. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, in attendance, we have 100% attendance today. We're Commissioner, Board of Commissioners, three members. We have Commissioner Chiricello. We have Commissioner Coyle.
Good morning.
And myself, Commissioner Godu. We're having a abbreviated meeting today. We only have a couple of items on the agenda, and we'll start with the first item, which is approval of payroll.
So with respect to the consent agenda, the payroll, I move to approve the payroll expense in the amount of $1,438,453.17 for the period ending August 10th, 2024.
Second.
Is there any discussion on that motion? Seeing no discussion, Commissioner Coyle?
Yes.
Commissioner Chiricello?
Yeah.
And I vote yes. 3-0. Okay, next we have a report from long-term care services regarding our salary line. We've got some information, and it seems that we're under our budget so far, but I'm gonna let Michelle and Kendra chime in and tell us what's happening and what we need to know that's pertinent.
Sure, actually I'm gonna hand it over Kathy. To Elaine.
Elaine, okay. Yep.
So I'm passing out a revised, it's not changed too much, but in working with payroll, there were some adjustments to the system that we were using where we found a couple of incorrect salaries that were input into UKG for travelers. So, and then I was pulling reports on Monday, but there's adjustments throughout the week that I should wait until Friday to pull the report. So as you can see, like for the first week, it was 508. It's actually 515 after some of those adjustments were made. The percentage hasn't changed all too much, but it is a little bit higher. And I just wanted to make sure that you got correct numbers.
So we're still under budget correct. As I buy it.
Like 1.25%.
Yeah, 1.25. Thank you.
Yeah, and payroll did let me know that when the quarterly meetings with the delegation, all of those adjustments will be made. And so we've also developed a detailed report so that now we can go to each number and make sure that there's nothing incorrect in those numbers. We can look for discrepancies, and we have our person who's doing all of the agency billing, comparing rates, comparing payroll dollars and UKG against what the invoices, what we're being invoiced for those agency staff.
Does this include all of the agency salary?
All agency and all
out there. Yeah. Okay, so this is a full picture
all inclusive
of our salary.
Three pay periods in.
That's correct.
I appreciate the effort to track this in a way. This is like brand new and this is fantastic. Thank you so much for the team getting together and making all this effort to give us this data. We can now, having this tracking will be so helpful. And if we can, again, merge that with some of the from an HR side of the recruiting, it's great. Thank you. Yeah. We're not going to be in the same situation this year. I mean, we learned from our mistakes, and this year is going to be far different than it was last year. So thank you.
It's clear and concise. Is there anything else that we need to discuss on this topic? Anything else that we need to know?
I guess, I have a question. Kendra, how are you doing with respect to assisted living and staffing from your side?
So just to speak on Monday, we started a full-time LNA for third shift. So we'll be releasing one of our contracted agency staff at the end of the month. So then we will be down to two agency staff
for
assisted living.
Excellent.
So one of our goals over in assisted living, specifically for Jen, who's our assistant wellness manager, her and I have really been working hard to be, the goal by December is to be 100% free of contracted staff that we signed contracted staff with. So we're headed in that direction. We're not quite there yet, but One full-time staff member is a way to get there.
Yeah.
So slowly but surely.
Well, I mean, you're 33% of the way there, on the, right? So like every little bit, I mean, every contracted individual get out is, if in replacement of a staff, is exactly what we want. And it's not just the financial end of it. It's the consistency and care and the, you know, being part of our community. It just, I think it makes a difference in care and the teamwork.
The hope is also that maybe she enjoys working with us. So then maybe she knows someone who will refer someone over. That's how our per diem pool has grown, is we hired one person into the per diem pool and word of mouth it sort of grew. So that's kind of the hope as this new employee transitions in, that maybe she knows somebody else that would like to come join our team.
Great. What about long-term care in the nursing area? Do we have any new hires or any progress on?
Yeah, I know that there's been a lot of prospective applicants that have applied. I know Autumn's been very, very busy vetting out certain people and bringing some people on board. I don't know, Allison, if she wants to see if she knows the exact.
Yes, I am very happy to announce that we have 3 LNAs hired. Offers went out and accepted. So that's a good thing. So there is some motion with the stipend being advertised out there. And we've had 2 interests in our LNA apprentice program as well, which we revamped as well. So Autumn is following up on that. And we may have 2 individuals that will go through that fully paid and then come on to the long-term care side once they complete their certifications and process. So I think that's also very positive news right there.
That is outstanding. I mean, to see some movement with the stipends really just being implemented, that's great news. That's great news.
I agree. If we stay on this path, the salary line should be well below what we budgeted. So we budgeted for the worst, and hopefully we come in. These changes make a difference, and it looks like we're on the right track. So congratulations.
And again, this is all part, like, budget is like was a focus, but also the quality of care, just in terms of the
prospect of the
residents, is really what is so important. So,
okay, so
thank you again.
I think that concludes this discussion. Do we have some new business? Commissioner Coyle indicated she had some new business she wanted to discuss.
I just wanted to bring something to the attention of on Friday, something that happened to me personally, and I just going forward on Friday, I received a call from a purported news investigator. He was aggressive, threatening. It was pretty alarming. I felt pretty alarmed by it. And he made accusations against me and also against certain members of the senior leadership team here at the county. I was really quite taken aback, and he asked to schedule an interview. He asked to schedule an interview on Sunday, and I came to the county in purports to meet with him, because particularly, I mean, it doesn't bother me. It was like alarming and really concerning the way he was, sort of the nature of his aggressive approach. And it was, but what most concerned me is that he was trying to smear and undermine and disparage members of our senior leadership team. I showed up, the whole thing was a hoax. It was someone, I don't know how they got my cell phone number or what took place, but the whole thing was a hoax. And the good news is that I've practiced criminal law for a long time, and I reported it to the police department. The police are actively investigating. It was a blocked number, but fortunately, in the day and age of cell phones, phone records can get subpoenaed, and they should be able to determine who was responsible for this. I did, I mean, I don't know, Commissioner Godu, I don't know what the contents of, I know you showed up too, and I don't know what the contents of your phone call were, but I guess what I'd like to emphasize is, I am not going to stand for the disparagement of our community, completely unsubstantiated, unwarranted, and improper. And I don't care who it is, I'm going to take action, because it really distressed me that there could be so much animosity. I mean, it's fine, I'm the elected official, it's okay, I can take it, but for our senior leadership team and everybody that's working so hard. So I just wanted to put that out there.
I'll just chime in that I received a very similar phone call. It was a 42-minute phone call. As I reviewed the facts, it was very aggressive, accusatory of not only me, but senior staff. And I was fooled. And I showed up as well on Sunday for what was supposed to be an interview with WMUR, investigative reporting, that was supposed to air on Monday evening. When they didn't show up, I called WMUR and they knew nothing of the reporter or any investigation. And I guess in some respects I was relieved, but I have to tell you that I was very upset at the circumstance personally. And I'm glad it's over. I also filed a police report, and there's a detective looking to figure out who made the phone call, and we'll see what happens.
The point is, I mean, I guess if I have any takeaway is, I feel the utmost confidence in our team here, and I have no problem going to bat for anybody when I see the people being improperly and unfairly and being smeared. Just that simple. So
what was said?
I'll just add that all of the accusations were false. There was nothing truthful. And with respect to what was said, I would prefer not to repeat it, because it would only be repeating a hoax and a lie that somebody perpetrated. And I certainly don't want to continue the rumor mill. All I can tell you is that it was serious, and there were serious accusations, and I felt like I had no choice but to come and answer the questions, because I was convinced, I mean, this guy was really good. I was convinced that he was a real reporter and that he was going to report on Monday night, and my silence would sound like guilt and guilt of the other accusations. Well, and so I had to go and defend what we were doing here at the county, because there's nothing wrong with what's going on here. We're doing a great job, and all the staff and
our team.
They're all doing a great job. So I just would like to leave it at that.
Chime in for a minute, because I did not get any phone call, with the exception of a police officer from Haverhill, Massachusetts, who asked me what I knew about it, and I told him what I know, which was from John Janigian talking to Commissioner Godu, and that was it. That was the conversation. So it almost sounds like you of pointing a finger at me, which bring on the detectives or whatever you want to do. That's kind of with me. I knew nothing about it. It had nothing to do with anything. So it's kind of strange that they pick on you two and not me, but whatever.
Yeah, it is kind of strange.
He must have been very convincing if he fooled the both of you.
He was.
So I'm not, first off, I'm not that creative. So.
Fair enough.
But I'm happy to discuss with anybody, Able Police, whatever you want to do. Book me up to a lie detector test if you want.
I'm making notes.
I'd like to know what the disparaging of our leadership is as well, because I will not stand for that. That's uncalled for and unprofessional. So Maybe you guys can fill me in a non-public.
Well, I just want to emphasize that I'm not accusing you of anything. I have no proof of, and really no idea where it really came from. And I just filed the report because I was harassed. And it seemed like the appropriate thing to do, and they'll do what they will with the report. I mean, it's not like somebody committed murder. I don't know that it's the highest, you know, on anyone's priority list. I got a prank phone call. I guess you could get it down to that. But boy, it was a good one. It was very upsetting.
Well, it's the going after our team here. And to your point, the need to like defend and reply to and not just accept those things that was so troubling to me. So anyway, that will continue.
Okay. Is there anything else that we need to discuss? Any members of the public? I don't believe it here. So there's no public comment. I'd entertain the motion to adjourn.
So moved.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. We're adjourned. Thank you very much.